welcome back to Island Life. In Bimini, we spoke with many interesting people, none more interesting than Ashley Saunders. This retired teacher, poet, historian, and builder loves his Bimini and is committed to preserving its history through the collection of relics and artifacts housed in the bookstore and museum in Dolphing House, which he built. It appears to be the sturdiest and most unique house on the island. What is the inspiration for Dolphin House?
Well, I went swimming with wild dolphin many years ago, and they touched something in me that was asleep. And I became, you know, inspired. And I wanted to give something back to the dolphins. And so I decided to build a house that would, as a tribute, a monument to the wild dolphins of Bimini.
This is a unique house. Could you describe some of the material that it's built with?
Well, it's built from native limestone rock, also coral rock, conch shells, driftwood, beach glass, and recycled tiles. And I've been building this since 1993, so this is 20 years now I've been involved with the construction, and it's still a work in progress.
How much longer do you think it'll take?
Well, most people think that I might never finish, that I'll keep finding stuff and still adding. But in my mind, I'm trying to complete. I'm trying to finish, and I work on it constantly. Every day, I do some work.
Saunders, who did postgraduate work at Harvard University and wrote two books on Bimini's history, marches to a different beat. And though retired, he still works every day on Dolphin House, which he calls a work in progress.
In the early stages, it was a one-man project in the very beginning, and people would just ride by and throw jazz and call me crazy. And later on, after they saw what I was doing, the same people who called me crazy came back and shook my hand and apologized and said, yeah, I'm doing a wonderful job. But I haven't been sticking to the rules. I don't stick to straight lines, for instance, or right angles, as most builders do. I do my own thing. My walls are curvy, and they have coral sticking out of the sides, conch shells, you know, things that most Bahamian wouldn't consider to incorporate into their building.
It appears to be a very strong house, is it?
Yes, I'm thinking of hurricanes, I'm thinking of tornadoes, I'm thinking of earthquake, I'm thinking also of wind, rain, sleet, snow, termites, and even rodents as I built. So I'm building very strong because, you know, Bahama Islands are prone to hurricanes, and so I don't want to be leaving my home to go seek shelter elsewhere. So I'm building this so I could stay in my home if a hurricane comes and ride it out.
He wants Biminites to draw on the island's rich history.
Well, I would like for them to continue to preserve, if I'm around or not, to build upon the foundation that I laid, you know, and to carry the baton on and my wake on, you know. I've only touched the surface. There's still so much more to write about and to put in book form. So I would encourage them to continue the work that I've started.
Other than fishing, Bimini is known for nefarious activity. What would you say to that claim?
Well, I think we need to, live decently and hard work by the sweat of your brow that you shall eat bread. And I think we need to, you know, base our life around those particular biblical words. And of course, to live an honest, clean life. And let's make Bimini that great place that it we known to be in the past, you know. And, you know, the opportunities are there for us. We just need to embrace them.